Hey everybody, and welcome to another episode where we blow stuff up. I'm just grabbing some coal that was right there. I could see it from the surface. Yo, check this out. Look at that. The torches. Oh no! Ah. The torches. You can. Good lord. You can use the torches. Use my sword on your face. Use the torches. Just walking around. This is just little cave. Got all these guys in it. There was another creeper that I killed before you guys saw. Yeah, I'm just down here grabbing some coal. But how cool is this? Walking around with a torch like that? Now, I don't believe... Yeah, if I put in my offhand, it doesn't work for whatever reason. But I came down here for this. And all of this. I love anything that has to do with experience, because I'm still trying to get the books and whatnot, the armor setup that I need for the dragon. Because I really want Elytra. Trying to think if there's really anything else. We could maybe make an ender farm. I've never actually made an ender farm. But I'm not opposed to it. Get out of here. Alright. I'm gonna go and dump this off in the Ferni. And I'll be right back. It's almost nighttime anyway. If you didn't see last episode, this is what we worked on. Not many people watched that episode, so if you're watching this episode, there's probably a good chance that you missed it. But anyways, basically, I made these docks, made them look really grungy and dirty, like they're used a lot. And then I started on this building, which is not done yet, and that is not today's project either. I really like these docks. And this wall, this whole area right here, this little section right here, really come together. In my wheelbarrow with paddles in it. But what we're actually working on is over here. Is this where we just were? We can block this off. There's nothing else down there. Cave is a dead end. Whenever I come across ponds or something that's underground and uncovered, which there's a ton of around here, then I make a point to cover them up because I'm tired of falling in them. I don't think they look good when they're everywhere. It's much better this way. But what we're working on is going to be back here. And if you can take a guess, what are you doing here? I wonder if some Enderman put that there. What we're actually going to be working on is a campsite. And I've recently been here chopping down trees, you can see. But I've prepared the area. That's weird that it's clinging onto the leaves from the tree that I cut down right here from that wood. Anyways, yeah, there's evidence that I've recently been here, but we're going to make a bit of a camp area outside of the town. I kind of wanted a smaller project to get us away from the town over here. I like small projects. I like things in worlds that are away from main projects that you can kind of just stumble on or stumble over, and you know, it doesn't really have any purpose. It's just there. It's very atmospheric. I think it adds a lot to a world. I mean, you find a couple of these by accident, you're like, how many of these are there in the world? You know, so that's just kind of the way I've always thought about this kind of stuff. But I made a tent here, and yeah, this is the design that I came up with. If you Google Minecraft tents, a lot of them are just a 45 degree, like, upside down V. Not very exciting. I wanted something that looked like it was being supported up at the top and then kind of drooped down like this. Well, that's what we got here. I have a wooden base on it, like it's anchoring to that wood or something, and I have banners right in front, so it looks like you like push the banners to the side. I didn't use white wool. If you're using a vanilla texture pack, then you could maybe use a white wool on this. But I didn't because our white wool looks like this. And maybe I can find... I know there's a lot of alternative John Smith texture packs. This is John Smith Legacy. So maybe we can find one that doesn't have those brown lines. I know those brown lines are good for building in actual houses using that wool for actual wall material, but we haven't really done that, so maybe I'll keep my eyes open. This is a big tree. How do you like the shaders, by the way? We're running pretty good frame rates in here, even with all these leaves waving around. I thought that would really be rough on the frame rates, but I'm getting about the same frame rates as when we're out in the plains. But anyways, how do we get started now? So what I want to do is have a pit going in the center of a circle of tents, and the pit is going to have a fire pit in the middle of it. So let's go ahead and tear this out and replace it with some dirt, gravel, that kind of stuff. I'm laying out... Hello? Words? Hello, welcome back. I'm laying out some andesite here, because I think it's a good dirty-looking stone in this texture pack. It looks like stone, but dirty and whatever. And that's what we're going for in this pit. I think I want a little bit more on this side. And then we'll figure out the center in a moment. But that's what we got. And I like that. Do we have any cobblestone half slabs? We're going to have to make some. Let's put some of this wool away. We don't need it right now until we make some more cobblestone. There you are. So I talked about my cat, my new cat that I adopted a few episodes ago. A couple times I talked about her. And she's better now. She was sick. Can I? Yeah, I was told, we took her in and we were told that it might have been like a new diet that could have made her sick. But she's much better now and very playful now. She was kind of like, when we picked her up from the place, she was like very energetic. And then so glad I put a bed in here. And then we got her back and she was very sluggish and everything. Well, now she's back to being really playful, so that's good. Get up from your tent, walk out and see that. That's pretty good. I really like the feeling, actually. I'm surprised. Like, woke up right here and you walk out. I was surprised by how immersive that was right there. Turn that off even for even more immersion. But anyways, let's see. What's the center going to be? Let's go right here. We might extend this more that way. I'm not sure quite yet. And I want... We don't have fire spread off, so we're going to have to get some actual netherrack if we want to light a fire at the campfire. So be right back. I don't actually have any netherrack. That's what it's called. Gosh, this texture is nice. It's not very gritty, is it? It almost looks like iron. You know, some textures use like a blackish iron texture. But anyways, I don't have any netherrack, so we're going to use coal for now. Maybe if we remember to, how about that? Yeah. Don't have a way to light it, but yeah, you get the idea. What was I saying? If we get some netherrack, then we can swap her out, and we'll be very happy after that. Let's get some spruce in here, something different from what we're using on the tents. It's very good to switch up. Let's not have that right. Well, I feel like this is really messing up our view here. But then again, I mean, it is a fire pit. Maybe that's fine. And then, do we want this right in front? Yeah, right in front of the walkway is fine. You have to walk in and around the chair and you sit down. Yeah, that's fine. Do we want to add signs to the edges to make them look more like doors? You know what? Why not? Let's get a few signs. How many are we going to need? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Do I have sticks? No. I think that's enough, right? Hold on. Gonna need quite a bit more oak, so how much does one thing give us? 3? So two things like that is fine. Right there. And right there. Alright. So, how are you guys? I've been so busy. If my uploads have seemed a little bit slow or something, especially Minecraft, because it takes so much time. Like last episode, I said not many people watched it. That was an all-day thing. Like I was building, I said 8 and then I got 6. I was building all day and I stayed up till 4 a.m. and editing. And when I had class the next morning, and because there's a little montage in it that's kind of just a fun thing. It's kind of stupid, but it's fun. And it takes a long time for me to make these videos sometimes, and this is kind of a shorter episode because it's just a small project. But I've been really busy with it. Finals are gonna be coming up, but first I got like the test before the finals next week, and then we're gonna build another tent over here, so I'm just gonna get ready with that while we talk. Then after that, I'm going to fly back. Hold on. All right, I had to sneeze. I'm gonna be flying back to where my wife is from, and I actually I lived there for just a couple of years. But anyways, the best man from our wedding is getting married, so we're going back down to her home area, and we are, how wide is this? These are 5 wide, by the way, if you were wondering. And we're gonna go see his wedding. I'm very excited. I haven't even met her yet, so I'm excited to meet her, and it's 5, it's a square looking down at it, right? 5 by 5, okay. It does not look like a square because it's triangle shaped, but so yeah, I've the point I'm trying to make is, trying to think about tools. Sometimes I get like confused when I'm switching out my tools, because does anybody remember the good old days when you used to be able to break wood with shovels just as fast as axes, and it was actually better because it cost less diamonds? Those are the days. But anyways, the point I'm trying to make is I'll be gone for, since I got more classes, I'm not going to be gone for very long. But I am going to be gone, so I've got to, like, pre-record, which isn't that bad. It's almost nighttime, but not quite. The sunset effects with these shaders always fool me into thinking that it's earlier than it really is. So we're just going to lay down wool like this. And then on top of it. But yeah, pre-recording, I might not have a Minecraft pre-recorded, or maybe I'll record one and then have it set to release while I'm away. But stuff like Fire Emblem, that's really pretty simple. Let's make a bed for that one too. I wish that beds change color based on what wool you use, kind of like boats now with their the color of wood. If it could change the color of what do I not want? I want bones because I don't come across very many bones. If it could change the bottom, like the wooden part based on what wood you use, and the sheet based on, we didn't put that all the way back, based on what wool you use, that would be cool. That would be something. I wouldn't be surprised if that's coming up. So we're in 1.9. Gotta remember that. The next update, I don't know what it's gonna be. I'm really hoping for a builder's update. You know, it's still not nighttime, and I was worried about it like 2 or 3 minutes ago. Let's add some stairs from this side, and let's actually use a stair to mix it up. Let's knock this back a little bit. Let's go like that. Is that the same? That's like the exact same as that one. Let's do. You know what? That's fine. It's getting dark. I think it's like really dark because of these shaders. You probably can't see a thing. Oh, look at the moon peeking through there under the trees. And then we should see the sun rise. Yeah, cool. Okay, so then I put a piece of upside down stairs right there for the banner to hang on. But yeah, I'm hoping for a builder's update where we can have like stair and I have such cluttered inventory and slab variants. I want this, and I don't want you. This can go. I don't need the wool at all right now. Yeah, we do. Need it for the banners. Let's just take that. Actually, we have enough banners pre-made. So like hardened clay, I'd love to see stairs and slabs for that. What else would there be? I wouldn't mind there being stone texture, like stone. I don't know. If you're making stairs out of stones, they're probably turning into bricks. So I guess that makes sense. Anyways, now we're gonna top off this with a way to get up there. Yeah, right there. So let's just put that there. Oh, a little bit of lag. Piggy! We need to start putting animals in our farm, that's for sure. Might be something to think about once we finish that dock building. But anyways, now we got this, so put one here. Oh, this is gray. That's fine. I don't mind that that's a different color. Don't think I mind. Do I mind? Like it. I think I do mind actually, 'cause this need I feel like it needs to be the same color as the tent, 'cause it's like a flap of the tent, so it's no bueno. It's not gonna cut it. Did I get my wool? Yeah, I did. I feel like I keep making sticks and throwing them away. Am I doing that? One. I wish this made two or three banners. I really do. All right, there. I just threw away my sticks. Are these? Why are these different? They're not different. I think it's just the light from the shader. Is it? Yep, that's it. It looks like the light gray, and they won't stack together. Like I had like two stacks that wouldn't go together, so I was like, what the heck? So maybe that's why. We should maybe try to figure out a way to add some variety to these. I actually feel like it's fine. Like they don't need a ton of variety. This is a pretty interesting area. That when you walk into here, and we're gonna have a trail coming back here. When you walk in here, I feel like the tents aren't the main focus. They're like, I mean, yeah, there like it's a campsite, but then in the middle of it, there's bam, this cool little fire pit. So I feel like that's maybe the main focus, but I don't know what I'm talking about. I usually don't. So I'm gonna build another two or three of these and then show you what that looks like. The sun is going down, but we are more or less done. other than the path that goes back towards the town, which is this way. I think I showed on video where I was walking from, but the houses are right there in the fog. It's about to get dark. But yeah, I like this area. I love how secluded it is. It's hidden away. I feel like we could do something with the backs of these tents. But for now, I'm not too worried about it. The way that I changed up all these tents is that I gave them different banner orientations. This one's got three. This one's got one. You get the idea. It's not much, but it just makes the flap look like it's kind of messier on some. I don't know. Then I add some fence and some bushes. I could maybe have used a different kind of leaves. Yeah, I could have used a different kind. Let's put that right there. To maybe make it stick out a little different. And likewise, I could probably use a different color fence there from the color fence that's right next to it actually acting as a fence. But we'll just say that's from this fence comes from that kind of wood. I mean, it does. But anyways, I added pathways. It's pretty much done. The only thing that I considered doing is maybe adding little walls here, but I think that just I don't think it's necessary. I think what we got is good. Something that I want to make note of, the other episode we were talking about, what do we call it? I'll call it environmental depth. So when you're building, we all know that you add depth to your build. You know, certain blocks stick out further than others to give it detail. Well, when we were building our bridge, I was talking about how it added depth on an immersive level, because when you walked over it, then you got this whole new feeling from being up on top of that thing, looking down at what are now docks right next to it. That's kind of like, we've got like a miniature example here. So, you know, maybe you're camping, whatever. You go up here. It's higher than all the others. I forgot. Slabs. It's higher than all the others. That's another way that sets itself apart. Not everything needs to be on the same height. Not everything needs to be symmetrical. You come out of here and you're looking down at everything. It's a very small example of it. And I'm probably just tucking out my butt when I'm talking about this kind of stuff. But I think it makes sense. You know, add stuff that not necessarily only adds perspective or adds depth from like taking a picture, looking at, it looks pretty, but walking through it. That's what I'm going for with these builds. When you walk through it, I want it to be immersive, not just, it's all flat. Oh, this is a nice house, but can't go in it. Oh, this is yeah, you get the idea. Is this, you can go down, go up. I think it adds a good immersive feeling. Put a tree there, or I'm trying to put a tree there. I have bones, but in here, I think. Yeah, I'm not going to waste them on that, because every now and then I need bones for dying sheep and whatnot, because I have some sheep back at the old town, the lake town, and they're like all one color. So when I want a bunch of one type of wool, I like get a bunch of dye for it and then dye them all and then shear them. And it's very ineffective. But if I ever need more white wool, which unless I change texture packs, I don't think I'm going to. Unless I can find a use for them. But anyways, I'm pretty sure that this has been a short episode. Last time I said that, it was like 35 minutes though. But what's it look like from up here? I think it's been a short episode, no major project, but I really like it. I really do. Let's get a look at it from here. Up here. Yeah, look at that. I'm going to make this our screenshot. Right there. I kind of feel bad about making the screenshots like the finished product, because if you look closely enough, you ruin it for yourself, kind of. I want to change this before we go. But yeah, here's a project that we're probably never going to see again. I don't know. I'll come back here. Maybe I'll s start a video in here or something. But it's hidden away. Well, we still got to do a path to it. And then we'll get back to work soon on the town. We got to get more buildings in here. We got to get, more immersive stuff. That's really what I want. I love this area. I really do. I could, we got our lake town that we need to get back to soon. Well, not soon, but sometime. But I just love this area, and I just want to keep working on this area right now. And again, the docks. I like these as well. But anyways, love these shaders. Anyways, if you like the video, then leave a like and subscribe. Thank you, everybody. Bye!
What I do, da da do, da da do.